I think there have been several fights in recent years that fans who are spending hundreds, sometimes thousands of dollars for these fights feel the scoring is not adequate. And in this situation where you had two judges score a close fight, which is what 22,000 people saw, millions of people at home, and one judge saw 10 rounds to two, I think what we want, sir, and I'm not trying to be a pain in the butt,
no, I'm just asking,
what will be done about this, because it's not the first time. Is there a plan to work with some of these judges to find out what they're missing that millions of other people are seeing? Because neither fighter won more than 8 rounds to them. That's all I'm asking, sir. This 10 rounds to 2 is just a little too wide. A lot of people here are scared to say what I'm saying. I might lose a press credential for the rematch for saying this. But I'm asking what millions of fans, I'm doing my job, because a lot of people want me to ask these questions that a lot of people here are scared to ask. I just want to know what will be done. Is there a plan?
G, that's how I scored it. You know, we give Canelo respect for, you know, his performance in the ring, but I think Gennady pressed the action, you know, on a continual basis, and I thought it was pretty clear for him. But like I said, the main thing is he kept his titles, and you know, what else can you say?
Abel, the same question to you, the 118-110 scorecard.
I said, I thought she had a card filled out before she got here. But I posed the question prior to the fight, when they were selecting the judges, and I thought that she was so up and down with her scoring. One fight she looks good, and then 3-4 fights she does terrible. I just think she needs to be reviewed. She can't be that bad, or she can't be that blind, I should say, that she could do that to so many fights.
You guys hear that?
Okay, what I was saying is that she had some issues with her when they gave us the list of judges. I said that she was so up and down with fights. She had one good one and then she had 3 or 4 bad ones. I think she needs to be reviewed. And I think she needs to go back to school and know how to judge a fight.
Abel, even though Canelo at times stood and fought, I personally have never seen him move that much in a fight. Did that surprise you?
It did surprise me, but you can't win a fight going away and getting hit with jabs. And like I said, I don't know how they judge that aspect of it, but that's not boxing. He ran for most of the second part of the fight, and you can't win rounds that way. Said to everybody before the fight, the first 3 or 4 rounds were going to be difficult for both guys, and we were going to win going away, say by a couple, 3 points. I thought that's what we did. I thought we were busy with the jab. We were busy landing the bigger shots. Canelo lands sporadic shots while he was running away. Harold Letterman, who has nothing to do with either fighter, both fighters are HBO fighters, had it 8-4, which is what I had.
Hi guys, Michael Montero here. This is a question for Eric and Tom. Is there any plan to possibly investigate Judge Adelaide Byrd possibly seek a suspension, anything like that. Obviously, this was not a 10 rounds to 2 fight. This is a very close competitive fight. And that scorecard left a lot of fans who spent a lot of money on this fight feeling ripped off. Is there any plan to investigate that judge?
Well, from our side, we'll have a discussion with Bob Bennett from the Nevada Athletic Commission. He's the one that assigned Adelaide Byrd. I'm not sure how far a protest is going to go, but we'll certainly have a discussion. We'll certainly have a discussion with him and see after he speaks to her, you know, what type of reasoning. Because I agree with you, Mike. I don't know how you can have 10 rounds of two the other way. It just doesn't really make sense. But, you know, again, the main thing is he's still the champion. It could have been a lot worse up here. So he's still the champion. And if the fans, I think the fans are going to demand a rematch. And, you know, we can always put that together and see who's, you know, who will assert themselves the second time around.
Gareth A. Davis from The Telegraph. Could I ask Gennady? I'm here, Gennady. Could I ask you?
Wait, hold one second. I'll answer. He asked me the question as well. Look, I'm open to either have a meeting with Tom and Bob Bennett. We can sit down with him and talk to him. I don't agree with that score either. I don't agree with it. But we'll sit down and you know, we're not the boxing commission. We're the promoters. And we have to let them, there's a process when this happens with the boxing commission, and we're going to be supportive. We'll sit down, we'll do whatever Tom wants. I have no problem with that.
Gareth A. Davis from The Telegraph. Gennady, congratulations on the most amazing fight tonight.
Thank you.
I wanted to ask you, and could you answer in Kazakh and have it translated? You've just had an amazing fight in what should have been the defining fight of your career, and most people believe you should have walked away with a victory. How does it make you feel when perhaps the judges have let down one of the greatest fights we've seen for a very long time?
This is terrible for sport, for boxing. You know, I'm a champion. This is the biggest fight for boxing. You know, if these judges, you know, like today, this is terrible. Unbelievable.
And presumably you do want to put the record straight and do it again.
He's just going to answer the second part of that question.
Yesterday you told me that if they didn't, the commission didn't...
You know, I'm a fighter. I'm a boxer. You know, if second fight the same, you know. For me, it's not my problem, you know, just I come into boxing. I come to ring, you know, this is, it's not my job. My job on the ring.
Kat Vrabel, you told me yesterday that if Bob Bennett didn't make Canelo trim his beard, that you would know what's coming with the judges. Did you feel that way going in?
No, he did trim his beard. It was a lot longer at the weigh-in. He trimmed it up on top. The judges, there's something that has to be done about the decisions here in Vegas like that. It's just unfair to the fighters.
Here's Bob Bennett from the Nevada Athletic Commission.
Hey, guys. So, I have some numbers for you. Final attendance was 22,358, which is the biggest boxing event attended here in the T-Mobile Arena. 17,931 closed circuit seats. So, look, all around, obviously, it was a great fight. It was a great fight. It was a great event. It was a great fight. Congratulations. Beautiful fight. I mean, that's what the fans love. That's what the fans love. Why? It reminded me of a few of my fights when I was back in the day.
Really good.
So congratulations. A lot of people are not understanding 118, 110, just like myself. That's the bottom line, but I have to say that Bird, yes, is a competent judge. She's been doing lots of world titles for many years. But yes, 118, 110, okay, yeah, yes it is. And I can understand 115, 113 and the draw, 114, 114. I mean, personally, I had it 7-5 Canelo. And people can argue it could have gone either way, because it was such a great fight. I mean, that's the bottom line. I think this is probably one of the best fights we've seen in recent years. These guys fought their heart off out. Gennady's a tremendous champion, and Canelo's a tremendous champion. You know, and everybody has their opinion, but that's what made it such a great fight. You know, and I mean, I do feel bad for Bird taking a lot of heat now. 118, 110. That was pretty widespread, I have to admit. But look, this is boxing. She's, like I said, a very competent judge and has been judging for many years. And Las Vegas is one of the best commissions in the world. So I personally felt that that boxing won today. I think boxing, it was a win for everyone. I think this is what the sport needed, a fight like this. A fight like this with Triple G and then Canelo.
We have Bob Bennett here now from the Athletic Commission, so I think if you have any questions for him, we could ask him now. That way he doesn't have to stay for the rest of the conference if you have any questions for Mr. Bennett.
Tom, I'm straight back here. I'd like Tom and also Oscar and maybe Triple G to address this question. Like Oscar was saying, you and Canelo put on an absolutely fantastic fight, maybe a fight of the year candidate. Unfortunately, we're sitting in a press conference talking about a bad scorecard. What do you think about that as far as the way the public reacts? They see a great fight, everybody's excited, and then they hear that scorecard and they're disgusted. Bob, I talked to you already. I'd like to hear from Oscar and Tom.
That's what I just asked.
Okay, no, I got you.
You heard me say it. 118, 110 is not, you know, people are scratching their heads. People are confused. What I mentioned was that, you know, I did see Canelo win 7-5. It was a close fight, yes it was. And I do have to admit, in front of Bob here, that 118, 110, and Bob is not the judge, but 118, 110, yes, it was a bit widespread. But what I am hearing, chatter and social media, I'm hearing, look, it was a close fight. It was a great fight, actually, because we haven't seen this type of action in such a long time. Did that answer your question?
Yeah, I'd like to hear Tom's perspective on that. Just that instead of just only talking about the greatness of the fight, we're talking about scorecards that people disagree with severely.
No, you're right, Dan. It was a terrific fight. Both fighters need to get credit for fighting each other and putting on that type of performance. But, you know, if she had scored it, or if that judge had scored it, that same score for Triple G, you know, it wouldn't have been that way either. So, you know, scoring it that wide for Canelo, I think it takes away from a lot of the performance of the two fighters in the ring. And frankly, it's just not good for the sport of boxing. Luckily, the other two judges, you know, it was close, could have gone either way, but I mean, I personally had it similar to the way HBO had it, and we had Gennady winning by a few rounds, but you know, like I said before, he's a champion, and he'll be happy to defend his titles many more times. Did you want to also get Gennady's perspective on that?
I saw computer, you know, all total punches. I saw reaction, people reaction, you know. For this, the Dodgers, it's terrible. For me, it's terrible, you know, just. This is not correct, you know, this is very bad for sport.
Question.
This is for Tom.
What?
Would you guys prefer to have a rematch in the Garden?
You know, that really depends. This was Gennady's first time up here in Las Vegas. I don't think it's the location so much as, you know, the judges. We think Kenny Bayless did a terrific job, fine job between two, you know, combatants that were throwing big punches. And I think Kenny broke them correctly at the right times. He didn't let either fighter hold, and he kept the action flowing. So we have to give him a lot of credit. You know, Gennady's fought in Madison Square Garden six times. He always feels very comfortable there. But, you know, when we made this fight, when I was negotiating with Oscar, you know, Gennady told me, it doesn't matter where the fight is, just give me the ring and get me Canelo, and he'll take the fight. So I'm sure it'll be the same attitude that he has for the rematch. And then we'll just have to, you know, maybe check the judges a little bit closer, just depending on where the fight is.
Thank you. Guys, Mike Montero again. I'm sorry, I'm going to be a broken record. This question is for Mr. Bob Bennett. Same question. Sir, with all due respect, we've had several controversial scores here in Nevada in recent years. Rarely anything is done. Obviously, this was not a 10-round-to-2 fight. This was a close fight. Neither fighter won more than 7 or 8 rounds. Is there going to be anything done about Judge Elliott Burke? Will there be an investigation? Maybe you'll sit down with her, watch the fight again, have her rescore it. What's the plan?
Well, first of all, I want to congratulate both fighters and both promoters. I think the fight was very competitive. Why don't you just be patient for a second? Stay away from the answer. You're asking me a question. I take full responsibility and accountability for my team. Okay? Adelaide Byrd has had over 115 championship fights or elimination bouts. Unfortunately, tonight she didn't do well. She was off the mark. You know, so
it's not the first one.
Well, I beg to differ with you. If you go ahead and look at her last 3 years for every fight that she's had, you'll find that she's very close to scoring every fight correctly. I have looked at her record over the last 3 years. I've got the records from Fight Facts. So if you've looked at them, then you tell me if I'm wrong.
I think there have been several fights in recent years that fans who are spending hundreds, sometimes thousands of dollars for these fights feel the scoring is not adequate. And in this situation where you had two judges score a close fight, which is what 22,000 people saw, millions of people at home, and one judge saw 10-2, I think what we want, sir, and I'm not trying to be a pain in the butt,
no, I'm just asking,
what will be done about this, because it's not the first time? Is there a plan to work with some of these judges to find out what they're missing that millions of other people are seeing? Because neither fighter won more than 8 rounds tonight. That's all I'm asking, sir. This 10-2 is just a little too wide. A lot of people here are scared to say what I'm saying. I might lose a press credential for the rematch for saying this. But I'm asking what millions of fans, I'm doing my job, because a lot of people want me to ask these questions that a lot of people here are scared to ask. I just want to know what will be done. Is there a plan?
Yeah, of course there's a plan. I will, I'll go over the fight with Adelaide round by round. She'll have to articulate to me what she saw, how she saw it, why she scored each round the way she did, and then we'll continue to move forward from there. There's not one person sitting in this audience that, in whatever their profession is, haven't had a bad night. She was off her mark tonight. So we will take appropriate action. We'll go over the fight. We'll look at it round by round, like I said, and we'll continue to move forward. But by and large, I can tell you, we train very hard here. We prepare for the fights. I do a lot of background before I make my recommendations to the chairman and the commissioners for the officials. And unfortunately, and I'm responsible for it, that, you know, Adley had a bad night.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Not at all. My pleasure. I should be asked those questions.
I just wanted to say we're going to have just one more question for Gennady because he needs to go back and take the rest of his test. Yeah, so we'll do Chris's question.
Just for Gennady and Abel, you guys had a lot of confidence coming into this fight that you could control it, that you would win comfortably, it seemed like, as you were talking before the fight. For both of you, did Canelo surprise you in any way? Anything that he was able to do that you didn't think he was going to be able to do?
I thought he ran a little more than I expected, but like I said before the fight, the first three or four rounds were going to be difficult for both guys, and we were going to wear him down as we did. That's why he was running, and we were going to win a fight going away by maybe 3 points, 4 points, instead of to Oliver, or knock him out in the late rounds. But I expected him to tire out and to run like that for us to win it by 4 points, which is what I think we did.
Not a lot, Chris, no, just, he talked too much before fight. He said he's true Mexican man, no, just at all. I bring him Mexican style, I want a true fight, close distance, like, no. He knows he need only decision, only 12 rounds. He moved all, every round, moving, not stay, no, just. That is a surprise. He moving, he not stay close to me, no, not front to me.
So with that, we'll turn it back over to
one more question. How you guys doing? Coach Anthony here with Behind the Gloves. First and foremost, I want to say congratulations to Gennady Golovkin and Abel Sanchez. Thank you to Golden Boy for putting on a great card. My scorecard was 116-112 for Canelo, so I don't feel like it was a robbery. It could be 115-113. So my question to Abel is, because Abel said that Danny Jacobs is the second best middleweight in the division, do you still feel that way, or do you feel that Canelo Alvarez actually proved that he may be the best, or in your opinion, the second best in the division?
I think him and Danny are very close together. I think Danny fought a little harder than Canelo. Canelo just ran a little too much today, but Canelo should be considered up in the top three, yes.
So with that, we're going to wrap up Gennady's portion. We're going to turn it back over to Oscar. We just want to thank you.